A modern playing racquet ready to reward aggressive swingers. This is the Dunlop FX 500 Tour. As the heaviest model in the FX family, this 98 square inch racquet still swings explosively fast and offers impressive blend of power, spin, and stability. It comes with Sonic Core technology with Infinergy, which does a great job reducing impact shock or vibration, while the new Power Boost groove grommets add even greater cushioning. All in all, a solid option for intermediate to advanced players looking to load the ball with pace and spin. We have been playtesting a bunch of blue rackets and they've all proven to be very powerful and spin friendly, and this one is just that. However, it also has a great amount of controllable power, which I love. I had a hitting session recently and I just couldn't find the court. I switched into this racket and I couldn't miss. So the feel at contact was great. I really appreciate the technology that Dunlop injects into their rackets that seems to gel with my game. I've liked it in their other models and it's no exception for this FX line of rackets. I'm able to swing big, but I'm still able to get my shots to land inside the court, so I'm really rewarded with that. And at net, the racket proved to be nice and stable. I didn't have any issues with floppy wrists or anything like that. And I found I could hit really big serves as well. I was very surprised with this racket. I actually went into this playtest with low expectations, but was super happy with how it played and definitely one I'm gonna keep hitting with.
I was very excited to be named to this playtest for Dunlop's new 500 Tour, the update of the older 500 Tour line. I've been playing with lots of 98 square inch hoops paired with 305 gram frame weights. This is another great addition to that. I know Michelle said she didn't have the highest expectations for it. I was on the other end of that. I've been enjoying these 305 gram frames. I had really high expectations. Compared to some of the 305 gram frames, this is a more maneuverable example. It's got about a 6-point tip light balance, a barely sub 320 swing weight, and combined with that 11.4 ounces of strung weight, this is a speedier feeling racket. It wasn't a detriment in terms of stability, but overall, this is just a great playing frame. It's got a nice uniformly wide space, 16-19 pattern, so spin was easily accessed. And really the only part of the court that I had any kind of issue with was on serve, and I kind of cured that with a little extra racket head speed. And then also on my serve return, I typically have kind of a half volley style, and it kind of coaxed me to use a little bit more swing speed and take a full cut at the ball. So overall, this kind of was a great play test, something that I could fall in love with without having to modify it. Just overall, a great versatile racket.
We strung our playtest racket with Dunlop Explosive at 53 pounds, and now let's go check in with our playtesters in Atlanta. How did this playtest work for you, Eric?
Thanks, Michelle. I found that this racket from the baseline is really solid. I had a nice blend of power and control, maybe a little more on the control-oriented side. I would want to add a little bit of weight at 10 and 2 just to bump up the swing weight to around mid-320s so I can hit a heavier ball and really get my shots penetrating through the court. On volleys, I found like this racket was pretty stable. I would, again, want to add a little bit more weight to up the stability just ever so slightly, but I found that it was really solid, very point-and-shoot racket on the volleys. I could really pinpoint my targets and hit my shots precisely where I wanted to hit them. The feel with this racket, it's a little bit more muted than I would prefer, and I would want to feel maybe a little bit more connected to the ball, just a minor complaint for me. On serves, I found that the serves are really, really solid. It was probably one of my favorite areas besides volleys. This racket is definitely a really whippy racket, so you can definitely get a lot of racket head speed and really hit some nice bombs with this racket. So really nice racket on serves. On returns, I felt like this racket really absorbed pace well, especially when my opponent was hitting a really hard serve at me. I feel like I could really absorb the pace and redirect my shots with easy depth. Overall, I found this racket from Dunlop was quite solid. I would just want to add a little bit of weight to get it up to my personal spec. We strung this Dunlop FX 500 Tour with Dunlop Explosive and Solingo Hyper G at 53 pounds. For more information on this racket or anything else tennis related, be sure to head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.